Okay, in this series of video lectures, we're going to go ahead and talk about what's called the Phillips curve. And the Phillips curve is something that economists use to look at the relationship between unemployment and inflation, because those are two things that people care about a lot. You know, if you sort of asked people how the economy's doing, likely they would sort of look at these two things first to think about how the economy's doing. And the Phillips curve is typically going to be a graph that looks something like this. And this was all sort of discovered just as a sort of fact before people had a real good theoretical explanation for it. So it was discovered as an empirical fact before people had a good explanation. And in particular, what people noticed was when we had relatively high unemployment, we tended to have relatively low inflation. And when we tended to have relatively low unemployment, we tended to have relatively high inflation. And roughly, this point over here corresponds to a recession, and this point over here corresponds to some kind of boom. And, you know, there might have been a whole series of different observations here, and the Phillips curve would be sort of the line that passes best through that cloud of points. So this was all discovered in the early or mid-20th century, so early 1940s to 1950s. So this is sort of in the early Keynesian period. So Keynesian economics really gets invented during the Great Depression and rises into prominence after the end of World War II. So what's going on here? Well, we can integrate this with our aggregate demand, aggregate supply framework. So remember, in the aggregate demand, aggregate supply model, we have the overall price level on the vertical axis there, and GDP on the horizontal axis here. And let's suppose we think about long-run aggregate supply being at this level, and then we're going to go ahead and have a short-run aggregate supply curve and an aggregate demand curve. And then we can go ahead and think about, down in this corner, what's going on with the Phillips curve. So remember that if GDP equals long-run aggregate supply, then unemployment equals the natural rate, or NARU. So this point A, our Goldilocks point here, corresponds to unemployment equal to its NARU. And typically the economy experiences some background level of inflation, say 3%. And let's suppose that this NARU unemployment rate is 6%. So the point A in this diagram is this point A in that diagram. If there's an increase in aggregate demand, then of course what happens is prices rise. So the inflation rate is higher. And there's also an increase in GDP. And when there's an increase in GDP, firms hire more workers to produce that extra output, so unemployment goes down, say from 6% to 4%. So this point B in this diagram corresponds to this point B in that diagram. If there had been a fall in aggregate demand instead, then we would have had a fall in GDP, thus a rise in unemployment, say to 8%, and the price level would have fallen, so inflation would have been lower, say 1%. So this point C in the aggregate demand, aggregate supply model diagram corresponds to this point C in the Phillips curve model. So key thing here, changes in aggregate demand cause movements along the Phillips curve. And just to be clear, because we're gonna make this more complicated here in a second, the short run Phillips curve. And in particular, an increase in aggregate demand causes us to move left along the Phillips curve, and a decrease in aggregate demand causes us to move right along the Phillips curve.